Escort girls of Reddit. Have you ever been caught by the client? So, how did that go? Got a call on my phone from an unknown number. I was at my laptop, so I typed the number into Google and hit enter. This was years ago before Google started fudging phone hash searches, and when it didn't load immediately, I went ahead and answered it. Turned out to be a tech from work who needed help accessing one of my systems. I walked him through it, then turned back to my laptop. The top hit on Google for his phone was a Craigslist ad for gay erotic massage. And it wasn't a wrong number, it had a couple months of ad history, and even though there were no face pics, his unusually hairy arms and a small tattoo were easy to identify. I kept that story to myself for a few years, only relating it after I left the company. I told the story at a bar with some old co-workers, not knowing that this guy's wife was friends with one of them. Anyway, my bad. A long time ago, the company I worked for had a similar situation. We had contracted a guy to do some programming for us, and he wasn't delivering what he promised. Looking for prior experiences others may have had with him, we googled his freelancing email, which promptly returned the many forum posts he had made on creepshit/voyeur forums. That still works today. Do not ever use your professional email for anything not professionally related. And that's it, folks. This is your job application. I anchored in Google Plus, Stack Exchange, GitHub, all the sites that you can use to point out and showcase your skills, and all the places I'm going to look. I guarantee you send in a job app with a goofy name or funny spellings. I'm deep googling that until I sniff out all your other weird online names. Not that I particularly care, but I for damn sure ain't gonna get burned, and I will kill an afternoon with a six-pack making sure this otherwise qualified candidate isn't in some weird near NA asterisk I group, or showing signs of mental instability. Sort of the other way round, but I found out the girl I was dating was an escort when she texted me instead of the client. True story. That's part of how I found out my girlfriend was cheating on me. She lived in a gated community and somehow her instructions in a text to someone else on how to get through the gate and get a visitor's pass bled over into a text she sent me. How? I don't know. And when I asked her about it, she denied she sent me that. She lived 42 miles away, so she knew I wouldn't just drop in. One Friday she lied to me about going to a friend's for dinner and I knew she was lying to me. So I dropped in. It did not go well, but it did scare the shit out of the guy. These are not times I care to remember, nor rehash in my mind, but 2½ years later it still stays in the forefront of my mind. I can't seem to shake it. 18 hours in and this has just become my top comment. Interesting how that happens. These misrouted texts are a godsend. My buddy found out that his wife was banging her boss because of such a text. She was allegedly in the boardroom in a conference she was at. She was texting him saying how boring these corporate stiffs are and how she misses him, and suddenly in the middle of that, a rather risque pic on Snapchat saying, "Come on right up, the door is not locked." There was no coming back from that. Thankfully for him, my country's divorce laws excessively favor women when it comes to custody. He sort of blackmailed her and said, "Equal custody, no alimony." They were making the same amount of money, and if she said no, he would tell her parents and friends the real reason for the divorce. As she was from a conservative family that was very well respected by her community, she acquiesced and they had a fair and amicable divorce. Wow, that sucks. Good for him, though. Who knows how long it would have gone on before he found out. Two wives of clients knew about me because their husbands flat out told them, under the sad misapprehension that once they were divorced, we'd be free to have an unpaid relationship. The first time, I was flattered, conflicted, and saddened. The second time, I was pissed off. You threw your happy home life away because you just /hope/some college girl was going to ride off into the sunset with you? Now I only do 2-hour maximum sessions because I've found that clients who book overnights or full day sessions are the most likely to lose their grasp on the reality of the situation. Somehow, sleeping next to someone is more intimate than f***ing them, and it makes these men confused. Can confirm about the intimacy of sleep. My husband and I work opposite schedules. He's night shift, and I'm day shift. We only sleep, as in actual sleep, together on the weekends. No matter what else we do with our days off, getting to go to bed and stay in bed together feels the most romantic. That's why I sometimes cry over a Beach Boys song. You know it's gonna make it that much better when we can say goodnight and stay together. X phoned a minitrix. On a call with a dude and someone picks up the other line. It is his elderly and disabled mother, and she needs his help to get out of bed. I tell my caller to go take care of his mom, and we can talk more later. His mom thinks I'm his girlfriend, and is so thrilled at the thought that her son has an actual flesh and blood girlfriend, that she tells him to finish talking to me. She can wait. I hung up, because I didn't get paid enough to deal with that. It was super sad, because his mom was so delighted that he had a girlfriend. I never heard from him again. Another caller hated his wife and wanted to be feminized while talking about what a his wife was and how disgusted she would be at his sissy desires. Once he got caught talking on the phone to me while literally hiding in the closet. Heard his wife say, "What are you doing in there?" My caller yelled back that he was organizing the winter coats while hurriedly zipping up his pants and hanging up on me. Same caller once tried to send me $500 in gift cards, but the credit card company called him to make sure it wasn't a fraudulent charge, and his wife answered. He managed to talk his way out of that one too. How much silver was this guy's tongue made out of? More like, how much denial was this lady willing to live in? All of it. Can we call you Blippi? Whatevs, bruh. Love you, Blippi. At this strip club I worked at, one of the dancers had a daddy that came in legit almost every day. He actually was good looking and charming. His wife saw his car in the lot and pulled in and tore past the bouncers and ran into the VIP area. They were back there. It came to seconds of them getting caught. She didn't get her tip that day, so he tripled it the next time out of guilt. So when I went to the strip club for my friend's bachelor party, I got a dance upstairs. So in middle of my dance, a middle-aged overweight Hispanic lady runs into the room and starts getting crazy with her man and the dancer. I felt bad for the dancer. She was a stripper dancing at a strip club. That's her job. It was funny though. You don't know people watching until you're at a strip club. Hey, what do you mean? You know the fun game of people watching until you do it at a strip club. Ah, people watching. Gotcha. Read that weird in my head. I should try that next time I find myself at a strip club. I can only imagine the stuff you see working there, lol. Anything in particularly interesting I should try and spot? I used to make like bets to myself in my head at how f***ed up the girls were gonna get that night. And I'd just be totally aware of your surroundings in there. Everywhere you look is interesting, lol. So people watch the non-active strippers? I would have thought you'd suggest looking out for something clients always do. I'm imagining a couple of the girls get pretty f***ed up by the end of the evening. I worked as a dominatrix years ago, and during those years I had acquired some regular clients. This particular client worked in another province and lived in another country, but all the same was a very good client. He told me that he was separated from his wife. However, when he went back to his place in the other country, she found my dom number, called me. She was asking me who I was and how many times I saw him and etc. It went okay besides her yelling and him pleading not to say anything. I don't even remember what happened after that, but he still remained my client after the whole ordeal. I do not engage in oral sex or intercourse with my clients. Furthermore, I remain clothed at all times. My understanding is that a lot of dominatrix don't engage in sexual contact. Some do, some don't, but it depends on the relationship. I could see the husband wanting to be dominated and the wife not wanting to do it, so they have an arrangement. Yeah, most legit prodoms will not have sex with clients. There's a debate to be had about what constitutes sex. For instance, strap-ons, but w/e, though keeping things from and so can create all sorts of other problems. Personally wish prodoms were seen more as something like a therapist, considering the good ones will work through a client's psyche more than they will seek to get them off. I met one who was a prodom part of the week and a chaplain the other part. So many jokes about doing the Lord's work. How does that even work? Was she secretly not religious or something? I can't imagine God smiles on that profession. So I was the girlfriend that caught my fiancé soliciting an escort. I found the texts and the link to the Craigslist ad. His reasoning was we had been having problems and he was never attracted to me. We just got along well. I left after that. I walked in on my ex soliciting dudes on Craigslist. I asked him if he wanted to experiment with men, and he said I'm not gay. F*** off and denied that's what he was doing. Oh, okay then. Maybe he was just ordering you one. It was M4 meter, haha. Haha, this changes what I was going to say. I was going to say that I've posted ads to the strictly platonic M4W section that were actually platonic and still gotten the random hey bro, no homo but I'll pay 100 to suck your d-. But if he's posting straight yo M4 meters, I actually snooped his ML later, I know, shame on me, and he told this dude he wanted to meet him in his car and suck his dick, and gave his personal cell number. So yeah, snooping is generally wrong, but in this case I guess you're pretty vindicated. Snooping means it's over regardless. At least you get closure. Not necessarily. Snooping can just be part of an abusive relationship. So not ending soon enough. I used to practically run an escort agency here in the UK. Started off as a driver, then covering the phones, did interviews, the photography and maintaining the website. Had two occasions of girls getting caught by spouses, but one sticks out more than the other. Had a regular client who would book a girl for 3 hours a few times a month when his so was on night shift. Not sure why she came back, but she pulled up outside about 1 a.m. with another hour left of the appointment. As she was walking to the door, I realized who she must have been, and got out my car to loiter for when the inevitable hit the fan. We had a policy the drivers would not leave the girls for safety. Not really had an issue, but helps the girls feel safe. Anyway, so walks inside. I hear a load of shouting, and make my way towards the front door. Girl busts through door wearing nothing but lingerie and a strap-on. We rush to the car, and start driving the 30 mile or so back home, when she realizes she forgot her bag. We's only made it about 10 mile. Guess who had to go back for it? I turned up. Police there. I knock on the door, and have to explain myself to the police. They hand over her bag and clothes, and take my details should they need a statement. Let me take girl home, and that was it. Client never booked again, and no idea what happened to them. Police never got in contact with either of us. Can only assume they were called out by neighbors for the arguing. I'm sure that was terrifying, but the image of her running outside still wearing the strap on is pretty hilarious. Looking back it was, but at the time I was horrified. It's one of those laugh at it later moments. You are a true professional, sir. Imagine if she yelled out, "You're next."